हेलो, आई एम आशीष द्विवेदी, पीएचडी स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम आईआईटी कानपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट माय रिसेंट वर्क विद प्रोफेसर नितिन सक्सेना। इन दिस वर्क आई विल टॉक अबाउट एन एल्गोरिथम विच कंप्यूट्स ए जीटा फंक्शन नोन एज इगुसाज लोकल जीटा फंक्शन एसोसिएटेड टू यूनिवेरिएट पॉलीनोमियल इन डिटरमिनिस्टिक पॉलीनोमियल टाइम। सो सिंस वी वांट टू कंप्यूट सर्टेन फंक्शन इन दिस टॉक, I would like to clarify what do we really mean by computing a function. Generally, it means evaluating a function at certain points, like in these two examples. You can replace the variable with the numerical values and you can compute these functions. So these are nice explicit functions and they also have finite description, so it is quite trivial task. But in general, function may not have this format. So for example, a generating function is a function which has infinite terms, like we see in this example, which encodes the sequence 1111, etc. If you want to evaluate this function, say at point t equal to 1/2, by direct method, then it is infeasible. Similarly, we can see this other example which encodes the arithmetic progression. So in these cases, it is more interesting to compute rational form of these functions than to evaluate, because if you have that rational form, then we can evaluating is just a trivial task like above two examples. So this function f has rational form and g is also a rational function for some feasible values of t. But these are very simple examples. There are much more interesting examples which are studied in mathematics, and subsume these two examples, like examples of functions which encode other functions. So it could be a generating function which has coefficient as other function, which looks like this. So f is a function which encodes other function g. So f is a power series and its coefficients are g0, g1, g2, which are other functions. We can see that this template encodes the previous two examples, as those are rational forms of simple cases. All right. So what is interesting is that if the definition of the encoded encoded function g is implicit, then it becomes very highly non-trivial to compute this function, rational form of this function f. An interesting example of this is Poincare series. So Poincare series encodes roots of a polynomial in certain ring, which is integers modulo powers of prime. Poincare series looks like this. So you can see that this Poincare series P is a power series with respect to variable t, and coefficient of t raised to k has nk as encoded function, which is the function which is the number of zeros of the polynomial f modulo p raised to k. So this series encodes the count of the roots of a n variable polynomial with integer coefficient. So it is not clear that even if this function has rational form or not, at least by directly looking at the definition. We will come back to this function later to see that how can we compute its rational form. Right. Now there are much more interesting examples studied in mathematics for which encode other important mathematical objects. Like these are called zeta functions. So zeta functions are important class of function which encode count of mathematical objects. So zeta functions are defined for various kind of objects. There are various zeta functions, but they have some common property, which is to encode count of some mathematical objects. And defined this way, very likely these zeta functions have special analytic and algebraic properties, study of which reveals very striking information about the encoded object, which was hidden otherwise, but revealed through the study of the associated zeta function. This fascinating phenomena makes the zeta function very, very interesting to mathematicians, and often it drives whole new area of mathematics. And why interesting to mathematicians? These zeta functions has applications to almost every area, like computer science, crypto, number theory, data science, even to study of the black holes. So an example which comes to my mind is probably the very first zeta function called Euler-Riemann zeta function, or also Riemann zeta function, which looks like this. So it's a summation of inverse of the powers of natural numbers, where S is a complex number and the real part of S is greater than 1 for this function to make sense, to converge. So Riemann, Euler defined this zeta function and studied for real S, but Riemann extended this definition to complex numbers and also revealed that this zeta function indeed encodes the distribution of prime numbers among natural numbers. So it's very interesting zeta function, and the famous Riemann hypothesis is associated to this zeta function, roots of this zeta function. All right, what other zeta function we can define? We can define some zeta functions which are called local zeta functions. These are called local because they are associated to some specific local objects, like associated to a particular prime p. So an example could be a zeta function which is associated to count of zeros of a system of polynomial equations which are defined over finite fields of characteristic p. This zeta function has a name. It's called Hessewiel zeta function, and it's very, very important zeta function. Its study has led to the development of whole modern algebraic geometry. Now you can guess the next zeta function, which is also a local zeta function, an interesting example of a local zeta function called Igusa's local zeta function. Its name in the honor of Igusa, as he studied these functions extensively and also found many interesting properties. So how these are defined? So if we have a n-variate polynomial f which has integer coefficients and a prime p, then a zeta function can be defined which encodes the count of roots of this polynomial modulo various powers of p. So the definition of this Igusa local zeta function looks like this, which is not important for our purpose, but what is important is that Igusa proved in 1970s that this zeta function converged to a rational function. Also recall, two slides back I talked about a generating function, Poincare series, which also encodes roots of a polynomial modulo various prime powers. So then it must have some connection with zeta function, Igusa zeta function, which is true and revealed, also found out by Igusa, that one can write Poincare series as a rational function of Igusa zeta function. So then the rationality of Igusa zeta function implies the rationality of Poincare series. And so we need only to focus now on Poincare series PT. I will denote it by PT now. I will remove the subscripts. Okay, so what is the problem? Let me take back you to the title where we wanted to compute USA's local data function. So what is known about computing these functions? Well, various methods employed to compute EUSA zeta function, expression for EUSA zeta function for a special family of polynomials, like the stationary phase formula, Newton polygon method, or the method of resolution of singularities. But not much said about their algorithmic aspect. Even some algorithmic aspects of resolution of singularities are known, but these are impractical. Indeed, just the root counting problem of a general multivariate polynomial is known to be NP-hard in finite field. So this makes us hopeless because the problem is infeasible for general multivariate. Well, what about univariate? So because univariate have many efficient algorithms in many different regimes. So can we do same here for EUSA zeta function associated to univariate polynomials? And they have better algorithms or better proofs of rationality, simple proofs of rationality. So that is our problem here. We are given an input, a one variable polynomial with integer coefficients and a prime number p. And in output, we want to efficiently compute the associated Poincare series. Basically, we want to compute two rational polynomials, a and b, which forms the associated Poincare series for feasible values of p. Note that this problem is also connected to problem of counting roots modulo prime powers, which is itself an interesting problem and has many applications like coding theory, crypto factoring, etc. This problem has been given a deterministic polynomial time algorithm last year to compute the function root count function nk, but this doesn't give explicit expression for nk. So does explicit expression exist for root counting function nk, or can we find this? This is also an important question. Let's talk about our results. So we give the first deterministic polynomial time algorithm to compute the Poincare series associated to a univariate polynomial of degree at most t and prime p. Recall the Poincare series looks like this. And we will compute, rational form of this Poincare series, that is to compute the polynomials a and b explicitly. We not only give rationality of Poincare series, rational form of Poincare series in deterministic polynomial time, but also compute explicit degree estimates for numerator and denominator. That is, the polynomial A has degree almost square of the degree of the given univariate polynomial F, and the numerator B has degree almost equal to the given univariate polynomial F. We also give the simple proof of rationality by first principles for Poincare series associated to univariate polynomials. Previously, Juniga-Galindo in 2003 gave a deterministic polynomial time algorithm for this problem, but his algorithm assumes the polynomial F to be completely splitting over rational numbers. Our algorithm makes no such assumptions and completely solves the problem. Even it works if F has p-adic integer coefficients. We also give a closed form expression for root counting function nk. And one important corollary we obtain, which is a property of this root counting function nk, is that it has it is constant if the associated polynomial is radical polynomial, that is, the associated polynomial is a square free polynomial, then this function nk turns out to be independent of k, which is indeed very interesting property. Okay, so briefly I will talk about proof idea, our proof idea. So what is the real difficulty in computing the rational form of the Poincare series PD? So recall, this is the definition. The real difficulty is that the definition of the encoded function MK is implicit. Although DMS-19 algorithm computes MK in deterministic polynomial time, but just computing MK for a particular K is not enough, as there are infinitely many terms and we cannot compute each of them one by one. But there could be hope if we have nice explicit expression for root counting function MK. So suppose MK F turns out to be a P power, like P raised to K minus 1. What about the rationality of Poincare series then? Then the Poincare series looks like this, and it has nice expression, nice rational form. So this is our basic idea. Our proof for computing the Poincare series goes through computing closed form expression for root counting function NK for large enough K. So the expression for root counting function MK looks like this. So we were expecting it to be a P power. It really not a P power, but it is sum of P powers. Sum of P powers, N P powers, where N is the number of P adic integer roots of given polynomial F. And Vi and Ei's are constants with respect to K, and coming from the given input polynomial F. So basically, Ei is the multiplicity of the ith root of these n p adic integer roots. Also, if our polynomial is radical, then you can substitute Ei to be 1 for each I, and you can see that this is a nice expression for this root counting function NK. So you can see that right hand side has no K, that is, this root counting function is independent of K in case of radical F. So we although we wanted a P power expression for NK, but even it turns out that this sum of N P powers is also nice, as we can split up the Poincare series into N many similar series, call the ith series PIT, and call the and also split up the root counting function NK to n many functions, so which has nice P power with some ceiling function involved, which can be taken care of, not a big deal. So then our PIT expression looks like this, which involves two parameters which are still unknown, but related to given polynomial F, Vi and Ei. Now, PIT has nice expression, and one would like to compute Vi and Ei. So if you compute Vi and Ei, then you can compute PIT, for which we use the algorithm of DMS-19. Basically, since it already computes the root counting function NK, so we encode, we equate the this value of NK with our expression, with some tweaks and tricks to compute the Vi and Ei efficiently. Also, for a small K, NK can be computed individually by repeatedly calling the DMS-19 algorithm, which are not these calls are not very much because K0 is almost T square. So this finishes the proof idea. All right, so time is going up. I am talking about conclusion. We gave a deterministic polynomial time algorithm for computing user eta function associated to univariate polynomials, but what about the general multivariate or for bivariate? We know that general multivariate root counting is NP-hard. It is not possible to get efficient algorithm for general multivariate. Thanks for your attention.